know you got to have your rest. She says, come lay beside me, I've been waiting since you left.
I'm confident in saying God designed humans to be flawed, and He designed love to be perfect. He designed love to be perfectly kind and patient, to be slow to anger, fast to forgive. He designed love to be a choice that we make every day, and He designed it so that if we choose love and stay in its presence, we as flawed humans might experience perfection. My promise to you, Angelin, is though I will make mistakes in our life together, I will keep our marriage in the presence of love. I will raise our children in the presence of love, so that no matter how flawed we may be as individuals, our family will be blessed by love's perfection.
Did I tell you, baby, you are the joy of my life?
Travis, I want to start out this letter by saying from the bottom of my heart that I love you so much. I tell you this multiple times a day, we know. But I've got so much love for you that it doesn't feel enough. I love you, I love you, I love you. That should tide me over for the rest of this letter. Our happy ever after starts today, and I want you to know that I'm the luckiest and most privileged woman in this world to be the one that you love and the one you chose to spend the rest of your life with. Nothing gives me more joy than knowing I get to spend the rest of my life with you. This gift is a reminder of our love. I will never forget the first time you sang this to me, and it will forever be considered ours. I've been dreaming of this moment my entire life. I solemnly swear to always support you and be the best wife I can be. Thank you for always making my dreams come true and loving me for me. See you at the altar. Love, Angelin.
Your smile, cause it can change my day. Sweet eyes that chase my blues away. Might be a touch that keeps me coming back for more. Loving words that keep me going strong. That art of hers I hang my future on. What it is, well, I can't say for sure. Just she's got this thing about her. She's got this.
Travis and Angela, having witnessed your vows by marriage before God and all who are assembled here by the authority invested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride.
I get the feeling that I
it is my pleasure to introduce to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Rice.
When she leaves, she's always gone too soon. Counting down the minutes till she's gone. She's the love I've known eternally. That always feels brand new to me. Can't separate the fiction from the fact.
In our quiet moments throughout our friendship, we always spoke a lot on God. Sharing a few beers around a fire or on the lake, our conversations tended to steer towards religion. I've always admired that about you, buddy. Your relationship and your stance with God. Those nights were my favorite days of church.
feeling that I've come back home. She's got this thing. In your favorite song, you just can't put your finger on. She's got this thing about her.
They say a marriage can't truly survive without laughter, and I don't believe there will ever be a shortage of that with these two.
I've had the pleasure and pain of being related to her for 30 years. I've never had a sister, but Angeline is as close as I could get, and I'm so lucky to call her my family.
But I will tell you, the moment that I knew that he was the one for Angeline was when we all went skiing. Every time I went down on my skis, this poor woman was laying on the ground. And Travis never left her side. He was really patient with her. I started to think they're right. The love has died. There you go, making my heart beat again. Heartbeat again. Heartbeat again. There you go, making me feel like a kid. Won't you do it and do it one time? There you go, pulling me right back in. Right back in. Stuck like glue. You and me, baby, we're stuck like glue.